At Canisius University, each course you take has a space on the web where professors may post various kinds of content and activities and assign or collect assignments. This system is called D2L, or Desire to Learn. Different professors use it more or less and in different ways. In this video, we identify the major components and commonly used features in a D2L class space. We're on a computer, and things will look a little different on a mobile device, but either way, if you know what to look for, it's not hard to find it. In other videos, we show in detail how you can use or make the most of these features for your coursework. Let's get started. The quickest way to reach D2L is via the portal, or My Canisius. Log in there, and on the left-hand side, click My Applications. In the drop-down menu, choose Desire to Learn. Once in D2L, you see the My Home screen. This is like the lobby or front hall of a building. In the My Courses block, you'll see your courses or group spaces displayed as clickable tiles. Along the top of the block, semesters and some categories like groups will be listed. You can scroll by using the right-hand caret and left-hand caret. Also useful are tutorial and reference resources linked via buttons below the My Courses set. The D2L self-paced training is a collection of short tutorial videos like this one that focus on particular aspects of D2L. Also helpful for new students is the Quick Guide to Technology. To enter a course, click on the tile or link for that course. This takes you to the home screen for a particular course. Here, I'll point out the essentials, but obviously individual professors choose what to use and what not to use in each course. For example, some professors use the news feed on the course homepage to post announcements for the class. But if there's anything at all in D2L for a particular course, it's probably in the content area, accessible via a link on the nav bar running across the header of most pages in D2L. In the content area, listed down the left-hand side are modules or folders. To display a brief list of the contents in all of them, click Table of Contents. To just see the content in a particular module, click the folder's name on the left. Some modules, like this one, may contain submodules, but generally, in the center right, you see links to items or content topics. These can be files, links, assignments, assignment collecting drop boxes, discussions, quizzes, and so on. Additional information may appear below the title of a particular topic. Also, some professors use D2L's due dates and availability date functions. You may see a due date below a particular item in the class. However, other professors may simply include due dates within the text or classroom instructions. So, if you don't see a due date listed here, don't assume there isn't a due date for a particular assignment. If your professor uses D2L to collect assignments, this happens in what we call drop boxes. This is an example here, and you see assignment listed below the Dropbox title. You might see assignments or Dropboxes here in the content area, but you'll definitely see any Dropboxes in the course within their own area by clicking Dropbox on the nav bar. So too with discussions and online quizzes. In D2L, discussions are similar to threaded message systems elsewhere on the internet. But in this case, they're limited to class members and provide more features for posting different kinds of content. As with assignment drop boxes, quizzes, discussions, or other tools, Zoom links for live remote classes or things like Hypothesis can also be found in the content area as topics or links. Be sure to read your course syllabus and other course instructions to determine which tools are used in your course. Specific tutorial videos for these tools are also available within our online resources. If your professor uses D2L's online grades tool, you'll get a grade report by clicking Grades on the nav bar. A few other tips when using D2L. Ordinarily, you only have access to courses you are taking in the present semester. Both before and after the current semester, courses are closed to you. Start and end dates may vary depending on the professor's preference. For this reason, you want to save anything you submit to a course online, including assignment files, outside D2L, somewhere safe. This could even include online discussion text, write it in a Google or Word document, and copy-paste it into the discussion in D2L. That way you have a recording of anything you created for a course, which can be handy in your future work. D2L can appear differently on various laptop and desktop monitors, but you can optimize any screen in D2L by using your browser's zoom. Typically, in a menu, you'll find a clickable plus and minus that allows you to zoom in or out. Search the web for keyboard and mouse combination shortcuts that do this even quicker. Take a few moments to watch our other tutorial videos. You can find them by clicking the D2L self-paced training button on your My Home screen. If at any point you have trouble using a feature in D2L, or something may not be configured right, email helpdesk@canisius.edu for helpdesk assistance.